Hello, it's Danny from SplitDiversion, and today I'm going to be doing a guide on how to use my Minecraft 1.8 Blender Rig. This is a follow-up to the speed rigging video that I published 2 weeks ago, and in this one I will be showing you how to actually use the rig. Getting started, you will need the rig itself. Now, if you don't already have the rig, you can find it on my speed rigging video, which I will link on screen with an annotation. Once the rig is downloaded, you will need to extract it. In this case, I am using 7-zip, however, you can also use other software such as WinRAR to accomplish this. Make sure you remember where you extracted the rig. Once it's extracted, you can open up Blender and start a new project. I went ahead and got rid of everything so that we have a clean workspace to work with. Now to import the rig. Go to File and go down to Append, and now you browse for the rig which you extracted. Once you found it, open it up, go to Objects, and while holding Shift, select everything except for Camera and Hemi. Once you have those selected, click on Append and you should see the rig appear in your 3D workspace. Now you may notice that the skin is missing. Well, this is because it's not actually textured. Well, it is, but it's not showing the textures. So you have to enable that, or you can render it. And to render it, you can hit F12 on your keyboard. But we can't render anything without a camera, so we're gonna have to add that back in. To add a camera in, you have to hold Shift A and then go down to Camera. It will appear at your cursor. Position this by hitting the G key on your keyboard and moving your mouse around. Now hit F12 to render the frame. You will notice that there is still no texture showing. This is because while the texture is there, the light source isn't, so you're looking at a big silhouette. Press Escape to exit the image viewer. Now hold Shift A and insert a new light source. Make sure it's a Hemi light. Position it and try rendering it again. Now that we are sure that the render is going to look fine, we can enable the texture in the preview mode. So go down to the little material ball near the timeline and click on it and hit textured. Now we can see what we're working with. If the skin appears blurred, you will have to disable mipmap. In order to do this, you have to go into File and then User Preferences. There you can uncheck mipmaps and then exit out. The following step is optional, but I will show you how to replace the skin on this rig. Click on the cube near the bottom left and switch over to the UV/image editor. You might see your render result. Switch over to the skin by clicking on the picture and selecting char. To swap the skin, click on image and then click on replace image. Make sure it is one of the new 1.8 skins, otherwise it will not work with this rig. Now browse to the image and click replace. Switch back to 3D view and everything should be in place. Now select any bone on the armature and enter pose mode. Once you're in pose mode, you can move your character into any stance. Hit F12 to render once you have your desired pose. And now you're done. You can tweak the render settings if you wish to get 1080p pictures, or change the alpha from sky to transparent so you can throw this into Photoshop and change the background to something you want. All that's left to do now is to save. Wait for the progress bar at the top to disappear and then hit F3 on your keyboard. Browse to the location where you want to save to and just simply hit the save button. And that's it for this guide. Thank you for watching. We'll be right back.